Play just underway here in this first place matchup on the girls' side of things at the U18 Showcase. It's the Nova Scotia U17 girls wearing the white with blue trim, left to right on your screen, taking on the Newfoundland and Labrador U18 girls in the maroon with black and white trim going right to left. Sydney Walsh getting the start in goal for Newfoundland and Labrador. And Caitlin Fines getting the start for Nova Scotia. So this game to determine the champion first place on the girls' side of things at this U18 Atlantic Showcase. Glad to have you with us here on Bell Alliant TV1. Just past 10 o'clock in the morning here on a Sunday, Atlantic time in Wolfville, Nova Scotia. 40-minute halves in this game, and if we are tied at full time, they will go straight to penalty kicks. Nova Scotia being coached by Gary Carter. And the head coach for Newfoundland and Labrador is Dragan Markovic. Assistants Mike Oliver and team manager Lisa Joyce. And on the Nova Scotia side of things, manager Kathy Burton helping out coach Gary Carter. There's Newfoundland up the wing now, Rachel Kylie. Kylie gets it off to the wing, trying to make a run down there was Destiny Mitchell, and Mitchell, or sorry, that's not, it's not a five, not nine, that was Chantel Armstrong. She went in there and almost had her back go into the bench on the Nova Scotia side, but she's up and okay. Play carries on. Here's Caitlin Fines corralling the ball for Nova Scotia. Up the middle. So it comes down to Nova Scotia versus Newfoundland to claim the championship trophy for the U18 Showcase 2016 version. One of these teams will hoist that cup at the end of this one. Ball crossed in. And a nice save made there as Sydney Walsh dives down to get it. Ball up now for Brianna Pender. Pender gets it up for Armstrong, and she just goes back to Pender. Pender methodically up the field, comes back to Armstrong now. She chipped it up in the air. Curry for Nova Scotia gets it over toward midfield. In looking for it there was MJ Miller. Back to midfield, controlled by Joyce. Katie Joyce gets it over on the far side. Newfoundland and Labrador now look to get it over midfield and into Nova Scotia territory, and they do. Long ball through there, blocked down by the back line, and Nova Scotia will clear it up. On the far side, down the line they come. Nova Scotia now on the attack. Getting some numbers into the Newfoundland zone. Seeing if they can work it in. Tried to get the ball toward goal, but it goes well clear. And out the other side. Just a little over 4 minutes off the clock here. So very early on in this first half, this game between Nova Scotia and Newfoundland and Labrador to decide first place on the girls' side of things at this U18 showcase. Final day of competition here. Six games on the ledger. Right out in front, cleared away. Nova Scotia trying to get another shot in on goal. And it came back, and that was lifted high and over the net, but not a bad chance there from around 15 yards for Team Nova Scotia. Sydney Walsh will take this goal kick now. Puts it up toward the middle, taken there by Nova Scotia. Back line for Steves. Jane Steeves gets it back to Fiennes. Just a reset now for Nova Scotia, back to Steeves. Steeves being challenged there by King Gesso. Nova Scotia comes up this near side, trying to get it forward, and Harnish and King Gesso come together for a moment. Play carries on now into the middle of the pitch. Play just around that midfield stripe. Nova Scotia works into the Newfoundland end. Holly O'Neill over there trying to get it for Newfoundland and Labrador. Nova Scotia now on the attack. Ball through. Taylor Green tried to catch up to it but couldn't. And it'll be taken now by Sydney Walsh, the keeper for Newfoundland and Labrador. 0-0 the score here. And this first place game for the U18 Atlantic Showcase. Over now for Pender. Brianna Pender gets challenged there, loses the ball. But Newfoundland gets it back. And working it back to the keeper there was Katie Joyce. Something you'll see teams do quite often when they just want to kind of reset, regroup. They feel a certain comfort level of just having it go back to their keeper and letting their keeper set things up. Beatrice Curry, who's been a strong performer for Nova Scotia here. Watch that ball go out of bounds. Newfoundland with the throw in now, right along that line, just in front of the Newfoundland bench. And here comes Kylie. Kylie works that ball forward. And just a little too far, as Holly O'Neill was the only Newfoundland player in the area. Nova Scotia comes down the far side now. Working the ball down that left wing. A couple of players heading toward the middle, including Beatrice Curry. Curry is there. Can she get a foot on it? Several players there. Curry whacks at it. And it goes just wide as Walsh out of position for a moment. And a couple of Nova Scotia white jerseys there. And a very anxious moment in the Newfoundland goal. And it just went off to the side. But it will be a corner kick now. Or a free kick, I should say, for Nova Scotia. This is McDougal. She tries to work it in front. And it just goes out, so it'll be turned over now to Newfoundland. And the Newfoundland coaches up, giving some instruction to the girls for Newfoundland and Labrador. Armstrong rolls it back to the keeper, Walsh, and she'll put it in play from the 5-yard line in the Newfoundland zone. Up ahead, King Gesso there, takes it off the chest, tries to put it down. Nova Scotia gets control. That was Green trying to work with it. Green chips it over now, and here comes Curry. Beatrice Curry works it toward the middle, tries to get it through there. Trying to work around is Hartland. Hartland takes the left-footed shot, save made, and Walsh down and grabs it. But another look at goal there, and a pretty decent shot, as Nova Scotia now has had a couple of half-decent chances in the last couple minutes. That last one coming from Alyssa Hartland. Here they come again. It's Green once more. Green has Hartland with her, takes the shot. It went off the back of Pender, I believe, and up and out of play. So Nova Scotia pouring it on here in the last 2 minutes or so. Coach Gary Carter, I spoke to him before the game. I said, what was your message to the girls before this one? He looked at me with a grin and said, attack, attack, attack. So pretty simple plan here for Nova Scotia, and that's what they're doing so far. They've just been on the attack. Here's another one now from about 25 yards. Newfoundland just covering up. King Gesso walked right by that ball. Nova Scotia keeping it again. Trying to work it over to the middle there was Taylor Green, and it goes out of play. So pretty good pace to this one in the early stages. Nil-nil the score. First place game between Newfoundland and Labrador and Team Nova Scotia. Shot in, they score! just like that, bang, bang, play. And it's in the back of the Newfoundland goal. Sydney Walsh up hugging that post on the ball in. And Nova Scotia, well, staying true to their coach's words, attack, attack, attack. And that's what they did there. And the ball ends up in the back of the goal. So in the 11th minute, Nova Scotia has found the back of the goal. And they are leading 1-0. We'll have to get confirmation on the goal scorer, as there were several players in there looking for it. And there's nobody on site here that relays that information to us. So I'll go down at the half and confirm that goal scorer for Nova Scotia. Brianna Pender back to the line now. Walsh gets it up ahead, works it up there for Joyce. Katie Joyce over to the far side. And that one goes up into the air and out of bounds. So Newfoundland and Labrador down early in this one. Trailing 1-0. Curry tried to push it forward for Nova Scotia. I've got to go corral the ball now and get it thrown back in play here. Make sure you join myself and Cyril Lunny each Monday at 8:40 a.m. on the Sideline Scoop. Get up to date on Bell Align TV1's local sports coverage with myself and Cyril. That's the Sideline Scoop, Mondays at 8:40 a.m. on CTV Morning Live Atlantic. So we'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning on the Sideline Scoop, and of course we'll certainly be discussing this showcase, and we'll have some highlights for you, and we'll talk about some of the upcoming events on Bell Align TV1. 27:15 left to go here. Plenty of soccer left to play. But certainly to this point, it's been Nova Scotia that's really been pressing the issue. And they've had Newfoundland and Labrador on their heels to this point. Here they come now. Down that left side, Newfoundland and Labrador trying to make a run. This is Joyce. And she just couldn't quite catch up to it. Newfoundland faithful in attendance here, liking that bit of work. Joyce now does nice work, gets stopped there by Harnish, gets it down in deep for King Gesso into the corner. She tries to cross it in, had it blocked down. It goes out over the line as Stevens just touched it there, so it'll be a corner kick for Newfoundland. So the corner kick now, and this is Jamie King getting ready. She just dumps it off. King will take it back now, work it toward the middle. King gets challenged there by Curry. Knocked off the ball, stays with it. Down into the corner, being watched there. Keeping her back to the play. Now she turns. Right in front there, headed away. And just white jerseys from Nova Scotia are there, and they clear it up. It's Hartland. Hartland in the middle of the pitch, trying to work it up ahead. Coming back with some pace now, it's MJ Miller. Far side, Nova Scotia trying to work it in deep once again. Play down deep in the corner on that far side. Work toward the front of the goal, cleared away. Back out it comes. Chipped up high into the air, Holly O'Neill got that away. Back line now for Nova Scotia, they look to work it ahead. Quick little pass up, picked off there by Torreville. Torreville, great player for Newfoundland and Labrador in this tournament. Trying to run onto it now is King Gesso, forcing that ball right down into the corner. It's cleared away. Coming up from the back end there was Armstrong. Over along the line, King Gesso just went by it. And then this is Green. Green moves it up ahead quickly there. Up along for Curry. Here comes B. Curry. Into Newfoundland zone. Curry trying to take it all herself. And good defensive play on the back end there as she was blocked by Brianna Pender. Throw in now for Team Nova Scotia. And it'll be Taylor Green to throw. Quick little throw in. Turning was Doan. Doan gets it off in the middle, just outside that 20-yard box. Quick shot in. And Walsh had to be sharp there as Nova Scotia put that shot in on goal. And it was a sharp-looking strike. But right at the keeper, Walsh.
Come on, man.
Walsh goes up now towards midfield with that kick, but it's turned over, and Nova Scotia will look to bring it back again. Picked off, and King Gesso now turns it the other way for Newfoundland, trying to find Toraville. She couldn't get to that. Back it comes to Chantel Armstrong. Armstrong works it toward the center. Looking to get that little quick pass up out. Looking for Joyce. Joyce decides to go back. Newfoundland trying to organize here and get some kind of momentum going forward. Newfoundland player gets knocked down on that far side, kicks it ahead. Holly O'Neill had it go through her legs. Nova Scotia now back deep in their own zone. 23:05 left on the clock here. 1-0 the score. Nova Scotia leading in this one. A battle for first place supremacy in the U18 showcase. Here comes Curry. Curry's dangerous. She's got Green on the right side, tried to get it to her, but it was intercepted, and Newfoundland will clear it up. Coming with it now is Joyce. Joyce goes to the back line. Newfoundland will reorganize back there. Moving up on this near side now. Pass up ahead for Armstrong. Armstrong trying to make a run past Curry. Curry jostles there with Armstrong, and the free kick awarded to Newfoundland and Labrador. Lovely day here. Mixed bag once again. I think this last few days here in Wolfville, other than snow, I think we've pretty much seen the four seasons. It's been cold, it's been warm, it's been rainy, it's been sunny, it's been foggy, it's been misty, been a little bit of everything, windy. Mixed bag of weather for sure. Pretty decent conditions right now, though, out there on the pitch. This is Miller. MJ Miller gets it off to the side. Holly O'Neill was there challenging for Newfoundland. Ball worked in toward the center in the Newfoundland part of the field, but they'll look to work it up over half now and get it into Nova Scotia territory. Here comes Toraville, trying to work it up ahead there for Kylie. Oh, nice. Kylie has it. Can she get a shot on goal? No! Kylie right there, but Caitlin Fines comes out from about 5 yards out to the 15 and grabbed that ball as Toraville tried to move it ahead for Kylie, and Kylie just couldn't catch up to it as a bit too much pace on that through ball from Toraville. Nova Scotia back on it now. Holly O'Neill over there. Sliding tackle misses for Newfoundland, and Nova Scotia carries it down into the Newfoundland zone. They work that ball around again, see if they can work it to the middle. Tried to cross it in front there, but it was blocked down. And then it's cleared out of play. Maybe hear the Newfoundland and Labrador fans below us cheering on their side, wanting them to get into the action here. Quick little throw in comes to Harnish. Harnish challenged there by Kylie. Kylie works it up toward midfield, where it's taken there by Stevens for Nova Scotia. She goes into mid, center part of the field. Long ball forward now, up into the air, headed backward. That was Pender. Knocked down there by King Gesso. This is Curry. Curry takes it deep. Tried to take a sharp angle shot from about 3 yards. And it goes well in behind the goal. So it'll be a goal kick now for Sydney Walsh and Newfoundland and Labrador. Just about at the halfway point of this first half, these two teams looking to claim first overall in the girls' division at the U18 Atlantic Showcase. This is our 14th game that we've broadcast here on TV1. bringing you every single minute of all of the games here, up to and including the final game this evening. Coming up with it now is Armstrong. Armstrong sent that ball forward and nobody there for Newfoundland. And Caitlin Fines will take it now for Team Nova Scotia. Big day here, not only this under 18 Atlantic Showcase taking place at Katy University, but also Convocation Day. Today and tomorrow, big day for graduates as they celebrate Convocation here in Wolfville at Katy University. So congratulations to all of the graduates celebrating Convocation. Coming with it now is Green. Green volleys that ball forward. Trying to run onto it there, picked down. Newfoundland trying to get that ball clear. Good job over on that far side. And ball goes out of bounds. Nova Scotia to this point has done a nice job at stretching out the field and getting the ball in behind that Newfoundland back defensive line. And they've had a couple of good chances on goal. And on the Newfoundland and Labrador side of things, their coach Dragan Mirkovich had a chance to talk to him a few times over the last couple of days, and the gentleman from Croatia said, you know, he honestly just wants these girls to learn the game, to learn the tactics, to learn the finer points and the nuances of the game. As we see Curry come down now, crossing it over into the middle. Nice effort there. Now it's blocked down. Off to the side, trying to find Curry again. Nova Scotia with some ball control now. Off to the wing, here's Curry again. Long ball into the middle, and Newfoundland forced to clear that out of bounds and take it away from the front of their own goal. But just to finish the thought on Coach Mirkovich, you know, he's very anxious and very passionate about the game, and he's anxious to teach the girls all of the fundamentals of the game. And he said to me more than once in my conversations with him the past couple of days that he really doesn't care about the result, win or lose, as long as they're executing the game and playing it well and using the skills that they've learned and using the finer points of the tactics and using the passing game and possession game. Here's a chance in front, blocked down. So another good effort toward goal. Curry now goes out of bounds. But so that's the kind of thing that's important. You know, these are young players, and to have a coach like Dragan Mirkovic teaching these girls in Newfoundland the finer points of the game, it's only going to bode well for their development going forward and also for the grassroots level of younger players coming up. Nova Scotia with the throw in now, leading here 1-0 over Newfoundland and Labrador. Lobbed in by Kylie, blocked down, and to this point, with 16:23 left, it's fair to say that the majority of the possession has belonged to Nova Scotia, and territorially, most of this half has been spent in the Newfoundland and Labrador end, and there's been certainly far more shots directed toward the Newfoundland goal than have been the other way. So perhaps Newfoundland right now feeling fortunate just to be down 1-0. Chipped forward there by Green, and it goes out of bounds once again, so it'll be a goal kick now for Sydney Walsh and Newfoundland and Labrador. Almost 25 minutes has come off the clock here in half number one, this first place game. It's always interesting. I know it's not on camera right now, but from my vantage point, I'm able to obviously to see all points of the field. And Coach Gary Carter for Team Nova Scotia, he's up off the bench and he's kind of keeping a close eye on things and watching. But for Dragan Mirkovic, he kind of lets his assistant do it. And Coach Mirkovic, or the Dragon as he's known, just kind of sits there and observes, watches. I'm sure he's making mental notes as to what he wants to talk about with the girls during half. Nova Scotia gathering in their own zone now on this near side for Harnish. Harnish. Challenge there by King Gesso, and the ball goes out of bounds. Throw in. Nova Scotia right along that line, trying to tightrope it, but it does just go out of bounds as Armstrong and Curry came together there along the sideline, right in front of our broadcast position. Nova Scotia quick throw in again. Curry puts her back into Armstrong, trying to defend. Armstrong quick throw in along the line. Working for it there was Kylie. Kylie tries to get it through the legs of the defender. It was intercepted now, and it's MJ Miller who goes back to Harnish. Harnish. Long ball through there. She tried to volley it in to her teammate, Burrell. Burrell couldn't handle it, but Nova Scotia gains control and sends it right back in. Newfoundland and Labrador now trying to get up to Torreville. Torreville has two defenders on her and loses the ball. Put through for Hartland. Hartland chips it off now to that left side. Nova Scotia working it deep into the corner on that left wing. And then it's sent out of bounds with 13:30 left to go in this first half. Visit bellalliant.ca/TV1 for webcast and TV schedule information as well as on-demand content. Also get information on live events available exclusively to Bell Alliant Fiber Op customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401. Bell Alliant, there's more to love with Fiber Op. This game, 1-0, Nova Scotia leading on the goal that they scored in the 11th minute, 12:52. Left to go in this first half, this battle for first place in the girls' division. They work it around now. And again, the flow has kind of slowed here the last couple of minutes with a lot of balls going out of bounds. Another battle over on that far side. Nova Scotia now work it back towards the center. Near side, Harnish. Harnish puts it through again. Headed down there nicely, and Newfoundland will clear it away. But again, possession coming right back to Nova Scotia. Back line for Stevens. Stevens tries to chip it through there. Miller was up looking for that long lead pass, couldn't connect. Down the line now, careful of that bench as Kylie came over.
Right away.
Nova Scotia with the throw in. Harnish back to Stevens. Stevens goes into the midfield area now. Long lifted pass. Chipped right back the other way by Newfoundland and Labrador. Torreville couldn't reach it. In there is MJ Miller. Miller dumped it off, and then Newfoundland take over. King Gesso has it now for Newfoundland, just in front of our position here. Up the sideline looking for Kylie. Kylie stops it there. Takes it back toward the 30. Little chip pass in for King Gesso. Torreville up toward the front. Can she get there? Right on top of the goaltender. Caitlin Fines has to come out as the ball was drawn in toward the middle, and Torreville was looking for that loose ball, but it was Fines who got there first. Holly O'Neill now forcing things for Newfoundland and Labrador. Nova Scotia decides to go back to their keeper, Caitlin Fines, and she'll bring it forward from there. Up ahead, Curry taps it up. Coming in with it is Hartland. Hartland got stopped on the back line of Newfoundland and Labrador. They turn it right back the other way. Joyce couldn't move it forward. Nova Scotia back once again with Hartland. And it's whistled down, and the free kick will be awarded. Taken quickly. Nova Scotia will look to move it up now. Pass off to the side. They work it back toward the middle of the field, and it rolls in where Walsh will just grab it and hang on. Coming up to 10 minutes remaining. So half hour gone by in this half. Nova Scotia continuing to lead 1-0. Ball up to midfield. This is Torreville for Newfoundland. Torreville He'll pass up the right side. Holly O'Neill trying to catch up to it. She gets there, but it just goes out of bounds, and Nova Scotia will throw in quickly and gain control. Nova Scotia go up the sideline to midfield. Newfoundland gets there first, and they'll just lob it back to their goaltender Walsh, who sets it in motion the other way. And in there, Curry tried to rush that play and intercept the ball. Almost worked, but it still comes back now to Nova Scotia. Little chip off to the corner. Harnish puts it in deep. Trying to run onto it there is Green. And it goes out of bounds, and it'll be taken by Sidney Walsh. a.m. local time here, Atlantic time in Wolfville, Nova Scotia, and 8:50 to go in this half. First place game between Newfoundland and Nova Scotia. Newfoundland trailing 1-0. Ball sent back there by Joyce. Torreville now spinning against two defenders. She loses it, and Nova Scotia tried to put it forward, but it comes on to the foot of Chantel Armstrong. She gets it over for Katie Joyce. Joyce back to Armstrong. And then Joyce again. Joyce tries to spin away, turns her back to the defender. Tried to chip it over, but Curry intercepted. Heading up the middle is Hartland. Hartland now. Curry heading toward the middle. Hartland gets challenged hard, goes down. Ball stays in. Another 1v1 battle. Hartland still on that ball. Another hard challenge. Great work here by Hartland, being hounded by Furlong. Right along the line, out in front, and it's chipped just away, but my goodness. Great solo effort there from Alyssa Hartland, as she had all kinds of Newfoundland defender all over the back, and she just kept working and was able to get that ball in front, and finally Newfoundland able to clear it away. Coming now is Harnish. Harnish rolls it through. Charging up there is Doan. All hands on deck for Nova Scotia here. Curry lets the shot go, and it was into a wall. Ball over on that far side. It's going to go out of bounds, and Nova Scotia will throw in. And right now, Newfoundland and Labrador under attack here. And in behind the play, a Newfoundland player. Slow to get up. To be okay. Brianna Pender, number 6 for Newfoundland and Labrador. It's down behind the play for a minute, but she shakes it off and good to go. Let's go. 6:35 to go here. Nova Scotia again pushing the pace, bringing it forward. Throw in for Nova Scotia. Ball blocked out. Newfoundland just trying to get it out of their own end and get some kind of organized attack going down on the Nova Scotia side of the field, but Nova Scotia just pressuring so much right now. Nova Scotia now, they'll go to the back line for Stevens. Stevens buying Harnish down that line, and they try to get the ball to her. And Harnish was making that run, but it was just intercepted there. A good job by Pender to anticipate that long through ball for Nova Scotia. Throw in for Newfoundland. King Jesso over looking for it, but they go to the back instead. Pender volleys it forward. Over there is Doan. Doan takes it and puts it to the back line again, and it'll be Stevens. Stevens rolls it along there. Up for Green. Green now goes to the back line. Quick ball through. Good possession here. Strong tactical game and technical game for Nova Scotia to this point. They've been executing their coach's plan almost to perfection here, and certainly full marks for the 1-0 lead. And it could certainly be a couple more than that. But Newfoundland and Labrador right there. Only down a goal. Lots of soccer left to play. Here's Harnish. Harnish chips it off there for Hartland. Hartland gets it through looking for Curry again. Hartland and Curry have been a dynamic duo here for Nova Scotia in this one. Here comes Harnish again. Harnish through the middle. Tried to chip it through there. And she just got stopped again. Newfoundland and Labrador now trying to make something happen. This is King Gesso. King Gesso. Through ball there for Kylie. Kylie has a chance and she's offside. Certainly looked that Rachel Kylie was going to be able to have an opportunity there. And so very close as a nice job by Newfoundland and Labrador to work that ball up ahead. And they tried to find her but whistled down and the ball back to Nova Scotia. But a close chance there. Best one for Newfoundland and Labrador so far. Ball ahead on that far side. 3:40 to go in this half. Play out of bounds. And counting. 1-0 your score. Goal coming back in the 11th minute. Throw in for Nova Scotia. They control it over on that far side, but it goes out of bounds once again. So the last few sequences have just been inbounds, outbounds, inbounds, outbounds. Sometimes you get those stretches where it's stop and start soccer for a few minutes. That's kind of the situation we have now. Head referee Darcy Bristol. I'll keep an eye on the time. We'll see what we get for added time. After this, Armstrong gets it back for Pender and then back to Walsh. Walsh moves it ahead now. Pender takes a look, surveys the field, comes up on this near side for Armstrong. And Pender, Newfoundland, just trying to set something up to see if they can break through this defensive posture being put in by Nova Scotia. Here's Curry. Curry stops now, goes to the left foot, tried to put it in on goal. Blocked away, and it will go to the keeper, Walsh. Walsh will put it in play here as time continues to wind down in this half. 1:40 left to play here in half number one of this first place matchup. Ball through again. Pender knocks it down. Nova Scotia continues to push forward though. Miller goes off to the wing once again and then Miller heads toward the front of the goal. Nova Scotia takes it down deep, curled in front, blocked down there by Joyce and moved upfield and out of bounds once again. Down to the last minute of game time here before we get into added time. Just throw in. Worked over toward the middle of the field. Backed in towards Newfoundland, but they pick it up there and they'll move it forward. On this near side for Armstrong, she's not going to get there and it'll go out of bounds. Throw in coming here, Harnish. Gets it up and falling there was Curry. Curry went into the back of Armstrong. She'll try it again. Curry and Armstrong battle again along that line and it goes out of bounds. So things have kind of ground to a halt here in the last few minutes as no flow whatsoever. Armstrong now will take that quick free kick over to Pender. Pender goes into the middle. Last few seconds here and then we'll get our added time. This is Lee, Kristen Lee, over into the middle. Ball moved forward by Joyce. 1 minute of added time. 1 minute. So we'll play with added time here as the ball once again goes out of play, and it'll be taken now by Caitlin Fines. Fines will take this goal kick. Get it over to Jane Stevens. Stevens, little touch up ahead. Spinning with it there was Green. Green gets it over into the middle of the field, out towards midfield now, over that center field stripe. Armstrong tried to get it there, was stopped. Nova Scotia able to move it up ahead, but Armstrong gets back to do a nice job of picking it off. And that minute of extra time went by pretty quickly, so this first place game has seen 40 minutes go by. 10-minute halftime coming up, just the one goal to speak of. It was scored by Nova Scotia in the 11th minute. They lead this first place matchup. Nova Scotia 1, Newfoundland and Labrador 0. We'll step aside, take a break. You're watching the Under 18 Atlantic Showcase presented live and exclusively on Bell Alliant TV 1. Second half action in about 10 minutes. Just about set for the second half of this first place matchup between Nova Scotia and Newfoundland and Labrador. Both of these teams looking to win this game, obviously, and be the champion on the women's or girls' side of things. Trophy presentation will take place at the end of this game, as this is a battle of first place teams. Newfoundland and Labrador wearing the maroon with white and black. They'll now be going left to right on your screen. And Nova Scotia wearing the white with blue, going right to left. And in that first half, just the one goal, it was scored in the 11th minute by Nova Scotia, and it was Taylor Green off of a header in front and got it in behind Sydney Walsh. And that's where things are. 1-0, Nova Scotia leading, one half to go. So Nova Scotia will look to add to that advantage. And down listening in behind the benches at halftime, Coach Gary Carter basically just, you know, wanting his girls to keep doing what they're doing and maybe just tighten up on some of their offensive set pieces. But basically, to use the term, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. It was a pretty solid half for Nova Scotia, as we see MJ Miller working it now. Newfoundland and Labrador trying to get it out. And from the Newfoundland and Labrador side, their coaches talked to their team about basically establishing more of their game and executing more of their game plan, rather than just chasing Nova Scotia around. That seemed to be the overriding message, was that Newfoundland and Labrador spent the better part of that first half just kind of reacting and chasing rather than anticipating and acting. So a little more execution from Newfoundland and Labrador, a little more initiative and action rather than reaction. So we'll see how it pans out here, and we'll see how those messages from the different coaches get through. Toraville trying to get it up now. Holly O'Neill down the left side. Can she work it to the middle? Has a 1v1 battle going there, and it's chipped up ahead and out of bounds. Newfoundland and Labrador would love to have a good start to this second half and establish more of their game. Nova Scotia, for the most part, really brought the game to Newfoundland and Labrador in that first half. And again, I think that was Coach Dragan Mirkovich's message to Newfoundland, was, you know, let's play more our game and make Nova Scotia chase us. Newfoundland looking to work it in now, comes into the middle. Stopped there and calmly cleared up toward midfield. Ball over on that far side. Holly O'Neill stops it there. Tries to work it ahead, but Nova Scotia now bring it down into Newfoundland territory once again. Ball over there looking for Green. That was intercepted as Green was wide open. And it's chipped out of bounds, and it'll be a throw-in for Newfoundland and Labrador. Ball up ahead. Goes off a couple of players, including Olivia McIntyre.
Come on, Destiny, let's go!
Here comes Destiny Mitchell now. Mitchell gets stopped up as she looked to make a run down that right side. And Mitchell watches that ball go out of play, and coming over to get it now will be Jamie King. Just want to give well wishes as well to Emily Walsh. Emily Walsh rolled an ankle in their first game and ended up on crutches and obviously was not able to play the rest of the tournament. Talking to one of the Newfoundland coaches, said, you know, nothing major, she'll be fine in a couple of weeks, but certainly Emily Walsh, we certainly wish you well and hope a speedy recovery for you and that you're back out on the pitch before you know it. Throw in now for Sarah Pittman for Nova Scotia. And looking for it there was Burrell, and that again goes up and out of play. So Taylor Green, the only goal here in this one, came back in the 11th minute. And that's where we are, 1-0 here in this battle for first place. Burrell in a foot race there with King. King hounding Burrell. Burrell falls. And much to the chagrin of the Newfoundland faithful, I believe Nova Scotia is going to be awarded a free kick. It'll be taken by Green. The goal scorer for Nova Scotia to take this free kick. Getting things set up here. Here's Green. Volleys it into the middle, and it's blocked down there. Nova Scotia gets control of it, though. Hartland puts it in. Rolled in toward goal. And no problem there. Put back into play. Chipped forward by Moland. Torreville there for Newfoundland, trying to pressure. Over on that far side now, Nova Scotia moves it up that right wing. Here they come again into the Newfoundland zone. With numbers, Nova Scotia tries to get it in. Nice job there as Pender was able to stop that forward progress from Nova Scotia. If you want to send out a tweet, use the hashtag TV1. Nice to hear from you. Let us know where you're watching from today. Any shout-outs you may want to do, just put them on a tweet, put on the hashtag TV1. Trying to run onto that now. Nova Scotia with a chance. Blocked down there. Several Newfoundland players. Comes back out again. And a shot along the ground. It just goes wide. A great effort there as Newfoundland was scrambling in their own zone. And Nova Scotia had a couple of looks at it. And the best one came from Haley Burrell as she struck that ball from around 22 yards. Put it right along the ground. And it just rolled wide. That close to making it 2-0. But it was a fire drill for a few seconds there in the Newfoundland zone. And Burrell almost cashed in. Burrell looking for it again now. It's up, intercepted there. Doan gets it for Nova Scotia. And they just roll it back to the keeper. Fines. Puts that well up ahead. Nova Scotia again and tacking into the zone here. Trying to work it toward the middle. Chipped away by Newfoundland, and it's up for Holly O'Neill. O'Neill working it up ahead. Up there is Mitchell in the middle looking for it, but it doesn't come to her. Nova Scotia intercepts, and they move it right back the other way. 32-44 left to go in this half. 1-0, Nova Scotia leading. And play will be whistled down once again. This first place game will be followed by our next game, which will be at approximately noon Atlantic time. It'll be girls action. And it'll be PEI U18 taking on the Soccer Nova Scotia club team rep. A hybrid team, mainly made up of suburban players. Still waiting on the official roster and numbers for that team that'll be playing against PEI at noon. That game will be two third place teams battling it out. Ball put in play. Shouldered over there by Mitchell. Mitchell in a foot race with McIntyre. Destiny Mitchell now taking a run. Shouldered off by Stevens. And the ball goes out of play, but not a bad run there by Destiny Mitchell for Newfoundland. Over. Ball put into play from Fiennes. And it goes over on the far side and out of play. Nova Scotia now coming up from their own side of half. Ball put right back in. Chip down there. This is Pittman. Tried to work it forward, but it's blocked down and out of play. Ball into the middle. Giving chase there is Doan. Gets it ahead. Quick shot from the right side and a save made as it just deflects off there. But another nice shot in toward goal. And Taylor Doyle had to be sharp and deflect that one off to the side. So Taylor Sydney Walsh played the first half. Taylor Doyle in now for Newfoundland and Labrador. Caitlin Fiennes going all the way for Nova Scotia here. Corner kick now for Nova Scotia. Low kick in, tipped away by Holly O'Neill. Back out top, stepping around there is Harnish. Harnish puts it in and just wide again. Another nice shot directed in at goal. And Doyle again diving to the other side this time as that ball went wide. But Nova Scotia now willing to take shots from long range. That's several strikes now in toward the Newfoundland goal in the last couple of seconds. It'll be another corner kick here. It'll be Taylor Green to put it in. Curving in, didn't quite get the distance she wanted, blocked down, and Newfoundland will clear it, but not away. Harnish knocks it down. Harnish tries to work it into the middle as the sun comes out now and covers the field with a bright sunlight. First time we've seen sun here on this Sunday morning. Newfoundland, perhaps with the sun, feeling a little brighter about their game as they try to make a run down into the Nova Scotia end of the field. Thrown in, blocked down there. Scotia just organizing on the back end now. We'll look to put it in play here. Goal kick for Caitlin Fiennes. She's going to get it up in play.
Come on, first try now, let's go!
Fiennes puts it up in play. Goes off the shoulder of the Nova Scotia player out of bounds. Quick throw in. McIntyre trying to chase it down. Right over as that was crossed in there. Good effort from a sharp angle. Fiennes handles it and sends Nova Scotia back the other way quickly. Into the middle. Nova Scotia working it up again now. Ball volleyed in. Taken by Doyle. Takes a bounce just by midfield. Goes to the Nova Scotia side. Destiny Mitchell here tries to get it for Torreville. Torreville tried to charge ahead, chases it down. Gets stopped there. Destiny Mitchell in again, trying to force the issue. She chips it over on this near side. Holly O'Neill gets a shot away, but it bounces off to the side. No problem there for Caitlin Fiennes. They whistle down, we have another stoppage. 26:05 and counting to go here in this half. 1-0 the score, Nova Scotia still leading. Make sure you visit bellalliant.ca/TV1 for the webcast, as well as TV schedule, and also on-demand content. Get information on live events available exclusively to Bell Alliant Fiber Op customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401. Bell Alliant, there's more to love with Fiber Op. Nova Scotia, nice little ball through there. Chip pass up ahead for Pittman. Good series of quick short passes there as Nova Scotia look to advance the ball up into Nova Scotia end. Pittman, quick throw in. Nova Scotia controls there. And Taylor was in challenging for Newfoundland and Labrador and forces the ball out. Over along the sideline now. Over there pushing out was King. Ball in, high into the air. Bicycle kick attempt there coming from Beatrice Curry. Just went off the side of her foot, and Newfoundland turns it back the other way with Holly O'Neill. O'Neill goes to the side, volleys that ball forward now, tried to chip it ahead. Right to midfield, bounces down there. Bobbed right back in again, and then right back the other way. Back and forth we go. Over on the far side now. Nova Scotia looking to work that ball into Newfoundland zone. O'Neill comes in and takes it toward midfield, and now it ends up rolling over on this near side where Nova Scotia will gather that ball up and look to move it forward with Pittman. Pittman gets it over there for MJ Miller. Miller looked to get it up ahead for Green but had it blocked down as Jamie King got it away. Here's Destiny Mitchell. Mitchell looks to work it in toward the center. She got stopped there. McIntyre will pick it up, and she'll just lob that ball right up the other way. Put back in there by Moland. Knocked down, trying to step around there is Abby Kennedy. Kennedy couldn't get through that white wall. Still fighting for it, though, is Toraville. She got blocked. Newfoundland having a hard time just getting through that back line defense of Nova Scotia, and then the ball sent down the line and out of play. 23:30 to go here, this second half. Still just the one goal, came back in the 11th minute. Taylor Green getting credit for the Nova Scotia marker. Ball put in play, and Nova Scotia over on that sideline, and it goes out once again.
Yeah, and the girls just looked at each other and the other team. Quarter, got it, throw. I
forgot that. Newfoundland with the throw in. Toraville had it go over her head. And the way this game is going, with, for the most part, Nova Scotia has been in control of the majority of this contest, but Newfoundland has hung around. And really, it takes, we talked about it in other matches, but it takes just one opening, one strike, and if they can equalize here, you never know what can happen. There's a quick shot right across the face of the Nova Scotia goal, out the other side, and not able to corral it and keep it in, so we'll have a throw-in now for Nova Scotia. But, I mean, that's Newfoundland. That's what they've got to do at this point now. They've had a hard time trying to work that ball along the ground and get it by the Nova Scotia defense. So maybe put the ball in the air a little more, try to lob it in and get some volleys in behind the Nova Scotia line and see what they can do. Ball again, rolls out, and it'll be a throw in. Throw in for Newfoundland. King throws it in, and once again, quickly knocked out. King will throw it in again. Waiting for her mates to get in position here. King seems a little unsure, but she gets it in now. Ball put forward. Newfoundland trying to work it in. Here's Toraville. Over towards the middle, and Holly O'Neill was in there looking for it, but it went over her head. But not a bad idea as Toraville crossed that ball over from the corner. And Nova Scotia now will turn it back the other way. Long ball ahead, that was knocked down, and again, we'll go out of play, and it'll be a throw-in for Nova Scotia. trying to work it to the middle. Newfoundland gets it there, but then it comes to Green. Green for Nova Scotia. She was challenged and taken off the ball. Green takes pursuit of King. King went down the sideline trying to find Lauren Taylor and just a little bit beyond her reach. And she couldn't run onto that one. But Newfoundland attacking that right side now. We've had a couple of runs down there. Substitution here for Nova Scotia. Coming into the game is Bria Bates, number 3, and Sarah Pittman comes out. So 3 in, 7 out for Team Nova Scotia. Caitlin Fines gets ready to put this one back into play. Over halfway now through this second period of play. This game to crown a winner in the women's or the girls' division of this U18 showcase. Newfoundland and Labrador now controlling on that back line, trying to move it forward. Chipped up ahead, Torville puts her back to the defender. Chips that ball forward, knocked down by Burrell. Burrell puts it high into the air. A couple of players there. Newfoundland gets it forward once again. Taylor was trying to get to it. Taylor still in pursuit. Ball comes down now into the possession of Nova Scotia. Moved up for MJ Miller. Miller gets it off on the wing. And just beyond the reach there as Burrell did her best to try to keep it in. But she just couldn't. And now it's right back the other way. Burrell along the sideline, moves it over, MJ Miller there. Destiny Mitchell now takes it down the side and it just goes out over the line. Be a throw in now for Nova Scotia. 1-0 your score here. 18:39 left to play in this second half. Throw in for Nova Scotia, this is Haley Burrell. Burrell throws it up the line. King was there for Newfoundland. King puts a little back heel on it. Coming over now is Sam Mullen. Along the line, King hammers it, and it goes off the Nova Scotia defender. And out of bounds, King quick on the throw in. Gets it up ahead. Trying to move it over toward the middle now. Little ball chipped forward. And that's going to go outside. And a throw in again for Nova Scotia. It'll come deep in their own end, about 3 yards from their goal line. They'll just give it off to the keeper. It'll be a kick now from Caitlin Fines. Want to invite you to join myself and Cyril Lunny each Monday morning at 8:40 a.m. on the Sideline Scoop. Get up to date on Belle Alliance TV One's local sports coverage with myself and Cyril. So that's the Sideline Scoop, Mondays at 8:40 a.m. on CTV Morning Live Atlantic. Hope to see you tomorrow morning watching the Sideline Scoop. We'll be talking about this very showcase, showing some highlights from it. Look forward to seeing you tomorrow morning at 8:40 on CTV Morning Live Atlantic. King now to throw in again for Newfoundland. Down the side, beyond the reach of Mitchell. Torreville was there and couldn't get to it. Anybody can be the hero at any time, but if I'm a fan of Newfoundland and Labrador, the people that I would look for up front that might be able to change the momentum here would be number 7, Nicole Torreville, number 9, Destiny Mitchell, and number 15, Holly O'Neill. Those would typically be the three that if they're going to change the tide here, it would come from one of those three. Moving it over now, trying to dig in was Taylor for Newfoundland. She couldn't get there. Nova Scotia now has it over midfield. Running onto that is Burrell. Burrell down the left side, puts on the brakes, works it over toward the middle. Knocked down and cleared away.
Go on, go on, go on.
Nova Scotia stops it there. Stevens hounded. Here comes Holly O'Neill. Can she get around Stevens? No, Stevens will get there. Holly O'Neill still going for it. So a good effort there by Holly O'Neill. She went stride for stride with Stevens right up the middle, and then finally Caitlin Fines decided to come out and roll into the pile and grab that ball. Newfoundland and Labrador now watching Nova Scotia move this ball forward. That went off the back heel of Hartland. Curry now through a crowd. Here's Curry. Gets it through. Here's a chance and a shot, and it's offside. So very close as Hartland worked it to Curry. And then Curry got it forward for Bria Bates. And Bates, just a little too anxious, got in behind the line just a bit early. She was free and clear, but just a little too anxious. Ball at midfield now, controlled by Nova Scotia. Tourville trying to hound it there for Newfoundland. McIntyre puts it over into the middle. Stevens works it up from there. Less than 15 minutes to go now. Still 1-0, Nova Scotia leading this clash of first place teams. Nova Scotia brings it toward the middle. They step up and block it down, and then finally it's driven a little clearer out. Nova Scotia works it again. Holly O'Neill all the way from the front to the back. Save made, cleared away. Again, having to dive there was Doyle. Another close call in front of the Newfoundland goal. But the important thing is the ball stays out and it stays 1-0. Ball chipped over there. Chasing it now is Green. She comes after her own pass. Goes in deep, and Pender watches it sail into Taylor Doyle, and she'll just gather it up there for Newfoundland and Labrador. Up toward the middle, trying to find Holly O'Neill. Tourville now comes over, takes it off a hip and down. Tourville chips it up ahead. This is Holly O'Neill. O'Neill, Destiny Mitchell heading toward the front. O'Neill working that ball into the 5-yard box and can't get anything further than that. Here comes Newfoundland again, working it down that left wing side, taking the ball in deep, and the Nova Scotia defender just watches that ball go out and then kind of stumbles into the end zone. Nova Scotia, the back line defense bending but not breaking. And Nova Scotia still clinging to that 1-0 lead. 1-0 long kick over midfield. Newfoundland lob it up ahead. Trying to get in on it there was Fleet. She couldn't get there. And it's Bria Bates back the other way. Bates being hauled, tugged, and pulled. And the whistle blows, and it'll be a free kick for Nova Scotia, so good effort there from Bria Bates. Taylor Green now with the free kick from just inside that 30-yard line. Hugging her goal post is Doyle. Green, the goal scorer here, sends it in. Work back out, long shot in, they score! Lobbed in by Alyssa Hartland from about 27 yards, and she got just enough air on it that it was beyond the fingertips of an outstretched Taylor Doyle, and Alyssa Hartland perhaps now has really put a lot of distance and made this hill that much harder to climb for Newfoundland and Labrador. 2-0 on the goal from Hartland. Well, sometimes it doesn't have to be a rocket to find the mark. And that was certainly the case there. Substitution now for Newfoundland and Labrador. Holly O'Neill comes out, and back into the game, Emma King-Jesso, number 13 for Newfoundland and Labrador. But just going back to that goal from from Alyssa Hartland, she, you know, it wasn't a rocket of a shot. She just kind of lobbed it up there and timed it just perfectly, and it had just the right amount of arc. And Taylor Doyle gave it everything she had. She climbed the ladder, tried to get the fingertips up, but it was just beyond her reach, and found the back of the goal. This one bounced in, and that'll be handled by Doyle. But it was just a perfectly placed shot. Just the right amount of arc, the right height, and into the goal it went. So 2-0. Nova Scotia leading this one now. The task just got a little tougher for the young ladies from Newfoundland and Labrador. Now down by two, into the middle there, blocked away by Pender, and that'll go out of bounds. Substitution here for Nova Scotia. Kara Fleet into the game. And the young lady who just scored, Alyssa Hartland, takes a seat for Nova Scotia. Corner kick now for Nova Scotia. Inside 10 minutes left in this game. Off to the post and a nice save there, as Taylor Doyle tracked that all the way, took it right off the line, and now she'll put it back into play for Newfoundland.
That's it, good ball. Good
ball chip forward there, trying to find Taylor. Here comes Toraville, and she just couldn't quite get there. Destiny Mitchell, I'm not sure if that was Mitchell or Toraville, 7 or 9 there, just tried to catch the number at the last minute, but a nice rush nonetheless. Corner kick now coming for Newfoundland and Labrador.
Come on, Jamie, come on, in the box, come on.
Curls it in, off to the side, headed away, and it'll be another corner. So they'll re-rack and do it all again. 8:42 to go. Newfoundland and Labrador needs a spark here. Can they do it off this corner? Up through a crowd, there's a chance! And it's blocked down. Well, they had a good look at it. I think Sam Moland was there, got a crack on goal, and finds, covers up, makes the save. Finds, launches that one. No shortage of leg strength there for Caitlin Finds, the keeper for Nova Scotia. Here they come now into the zone again, looking to work it into the middle. Blocked down, goalie comes out and slides to try to break that up, and it's out on the line. It'll be a throw-in for Nova Scotia. .748 and counting. Time getting short now for Newfoundland and Labrador in this second half as they try to come back from a 2-0 deficit. It was 1-0 ever since the 11th minute. And then in the 69th minute, just moments ago, Alyssa Hartland found the back of the Newfoundland goal, and that's where we are, 2-0. Ball forward now, Newfoundland trying to push forward. See if they can get something in. Try and challenge Fines in the Nova Scotia goal. Nova Scotia, well, just calmly put it back to Fines, and she immediately goes down the field with it. Jumping in on it there was King. She'll try to chase it down now. King follows it all the way to the sideline as she and Bria Bates went stride for stride. Burrell throws it in for MJ Miller. Miller, little chip off to the side. Nice through ball there for Curry. Curry gets taken down. Newfoundland carries on with that ball. Put right back in again. Here's Bates. Bates over into the middle for Curry. Curry tried to spin, couldn't get a shot. Back out it comes. Nova Scotia keeping that in Newfoundland territory. Over on the right wing side now. They'll try to track it there. Nova Scotia happy just to keep that ball in the Newfoundland zone and let time come off of this clock. Here they come again. Trying to get that in from 10 yards. Crossing it in and a save there, as Doyle had to go down and cover up the lower part of the goal as that strike came in from about 15 yards off to the side, and it was hit well. MJ Miller once again. Newfoundland steps up. They clear that ball down the field. Toraville will give chase. Toraville over in the corner, hounding the Nova Scotia player, trying to force the issue. 5:35 left on the clock. Newfoundland down by two. Two teams going toe-to-toe here. And a free kick awarded now.
Come on, take a shot at it from here.
So here we go, 5:15. So a free kick now from about 22 yards out. Dangerous territory. You can put a nice ball in here, make something happen. Looks like Toraville is going to take this free kick for Newfoundland and Labrador. There you see the wall set up by Nova Scotia right around that 15-yard mark. Here it is now. Toraville sends it in.
Yeah!
She scores! Toraville finds the mark! A beautifully struck ball from 22 yards over the fingertips of Fines. And it's a one-goal game. Don't go anywhere, folks. There is life from the rock. Toraville struck that ball beautifully on a rope over the fingertips into the twine. 2-1, Nova Scotia leads. Well, I said Toraville would be one of the people that you would expect to do some damage for Newfoundland and Labrador, and certainly off that set piece, that free kick from the 22-yard line. She just cracked that in on goal on a rope.
Come on, get out with it.
And a beautifully struck ball, and it's 2-1. Well, all hands on deck now for Newfoundland and Labrador. They are going to want to throw everything in toward goal here. Mirkovich up off the bench now, urging his team to push forward. On the other side, Gary Carter just calmly sitting there, trusting in his girls to be able to defend. They won't panic. But a little life here now for Newfoundland and Labrador and their fans.
In the box.
So, chance here now. Throw in deep. Working it over, and it's headed out. That's going to be a corner. So the last few minutes, Newfoundland has done what they've needed to do. They've put the pressure on. They've kept Nova Scotia hemmed in their own end here for the last little bit. They've scored a goal moments ago on the free kick from Toraville. And now it's Jamie King with the corner. Puts it in. It's up and tight. It's hitting this goal. Oh, I thought they had it in. My goodness, so close. That looked to be heading toward the back of the goal, but just wide. What an attempt on goal. The corner kick into a crowd. Several bodies there. The header put in towards goal, just wide. My goodness. Anxious moments for both of these teams. What drama here in this first place game. Up to midfield. Newfoundland and Labrador now. Trying to stay solid on that back line. Keep everything forward. Here comes Taylor. Taylor tries to get it through. Toraville chips it over on the side. They chase it deep into the corner. And it'll go out of play. Well, full marks to both of these teams. They've come out here and put on a real nice show for the fans here in attendance at Raymond Field, as well as all of you watching on Bell Ally and TV One. You'd expect two first place teams to put on a good show like this, and it certainly has been entertaining, and certainly the last 15 minutes has been entertaining and then some. We had Nova Scotia, the Beatrice Hartland goal in the 69th minute, making it 2-0, putting Newfoundland on their heels, but Newfoundland has kept coming, and just moments ago on the free kick, it was Nicole Toraville getting the back of the goal to make it 2-1. Here she comes again. Toraville taking it in deep, trying to fight for that ball. Now, last touch by Nova Scotia. So we are down to the nitty-gritty. Final minute of play, 49 seconds on the clock. There will, of course, be added time. Corner kick coming here. All hands on deck into the box for Newfoundland. Headed up, over, and just off to the side. So Nova Scotia knocked that one out. So a sub coming in here now for Nova Scotia. It'll be Madison Lavers coming into the game, and Bria Bates will check out. So late substitution here from Coach Gary Carter as Madison Lavers into the game. 12 seconds on the game clock. Corner kick here coming from King. Low line drive kick through a crowd. Cleared away and away from the front of the goal there. And King will chase it down. Quick throw in.
Settle it down.
Urgency here for Newfoundland and Labrador. 2 minutes of added time. So 2 minutes for Newfoundland and Labrador to keep pushing toward goal. 2 minutes for Nova Scotia to kill and to be the champions of the girls' division. Down they come now. Haley Burrell down the left side. Burrell puts on the brakes, looks to get it over there. It's forced out of play. It'll be a throw in now for Nova Scotia. This is Burrell. Just a great finish here in this one.
We're in the wrong part of the field, girls.
Yep.
Burrell, Nova Scotia, wants to keep it in Newfoundland zone, obviously. Worked up toward the middle. Toraville is there looking for it. A couple of players come together. King Gesso tries to move it forward. Here comes Toraville now. Mitchell coming down the left. Goes over to King Gesso.
In the box, come on.
Down the left side. Can they work it into the middle? It goes out of play, and I believe last touched by Newfoundland. So it'll be a goal kick for Caitlin Fines and Nova Scotia. We're in the final couple of minutes here. Extra time. 2 minutes was given by referee Darcy Bristol. And now free of the goal kick coming here from Caitlin Fines. And this is the thing now. No clock to look at. It all comes down to the referee's discretion as to when he blows that whistle. Newfoundland needs to get it forward. Can they run onto it? No, it's going to bounce down to Fines, and she'll just calmly corral that ball and will hang on to it and walk it up. No urgency at all for Nova Scotia. They just want the time to run off the clock. Newfoundland sending it down again. They need to get something towards goal here. Toraville chasing it. They've got to hurry. They've got to get it forward. Here comes Toraville. Puts the shoulder down, gets it into the corner. Stops it there. Up along, and it'll go out, so it'll be a throw in here. Had to take it quickly. Toraville heads it back toward the goal. Knocked down, long shot in there. And that is it. Well, one last ditch effort from Newfoundland and Labrador sails high over the goal. And that is full time, and it is a 2-1 victory as Nova Scotia, their U17 girls team, claims the first place and championship in the Under-18 Atlantic Showcase. A great effort by both teams. Nova Scotia came out early, came out strong, dominated most of the play. But in the last few minutes, with Newfoundland down 2-0, they really put the pressure on, kept the ball coming forward, got the free kick. Beautifully struck ball by Nicole Toraville, finding the back of the Nova Scotia goal, making it 2-1, and they had their chances. But at the end of the day, Nova Scotia comes out on top. A well-played game for both teams. Congratulations to Coach Dragan Merkovich for Newfoundland and Labrador, and of course to Coach Gary Carter and his Nova Scotia side as they earn the championship and will hoist the championship trophy emblematic of the winner of the girls' division in the Under-18 Showcase. So we see the teams shaking hands at center field. And the trophy will be presented here in just a few minutes. We'll show you that trophy presentation and then we'll step aside and get ready for our next game, which will come your way at approximately noon Atlantic time. It'll be PEI taking on the soccer Nova Scotia club team in girls action. So Newfoundland and Labrador coming over now in unison. Round of applause for both the team and the fans in appreciation for a wonderful tournament. I certainly think that Coach Dragan Mirkovic would be pleased with the effort his girls had, certainly in the latter stages of that second half. They could have easily rolled over and given up, particularly when it was made 2-0, but they did not. They kept fighting, kept coming forward, and had their chances, but just fell a little short. And for Nova Scotia, just a great game for them. They were solid from the outset, a very skilled side, very well-played game. Technique and tactic, both in place for Team Nova Scotia. And we'll see now as the trophy will be presented to Coach Gary Carter and the team from Nova Scotia, the U-17 girls team. I'll go down the roster. Cassidy Durston, Jessica Lush, Bria Bates, Olivia McIntyre, Haley Burrell, Katie Chasson, Sarah Pittman, Taylor Green, Madison Harnish, Alyssa Hartland, Beatrice Curry, Madison Lavers, MJ Miller, Kara Fleet, Alexandra Doan, Claire McDougall, Jane Stevens, and Caitlin Fines. And there it is. Congratulations to Team Nova Scotia, the champions of the girls' division of the Under-18 Atlantic Showcase. We'll step aside, take a break. Our next game comes your way at noon. It's girls' action, third place game. PEI U-18 taking on the Soccer Nova Scotia club team rep from Suburban. You've been watching the Under-18 Atlantic Showcase live and exclusively on Bell Alliant TV1. Once again, your final score. Nova Scotia, the girls are champions as they defeat Newfoundland and Labrador 2-1. We'll step aside and be back at noon.